Hello, I'm Joshua Price Cole, and welcome to Hop It Home Spring 2021 edition. We've got an absolutely beautiful concert tonight by Omar and Lin Guey. This is just the beginning of an incredibly diverse lineup of performances and conversations coming up this spring. Look for new installments of Hop to Broadway, In the Spirit, and of course Dartmouth Idol, as well as a new creative music series, new work from the Department of Theater, and a premiere from the Dartmouth Opera Lab, and much, much more. Check out hop.dartmouth.edu for the whole spring season. And as always, thank you to our members who make all of this possible. Hop at Home programs are free to members, and you can learn about becoming a member on our website. And now, on to the show. Enjoy.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining us tonight. I am Omar Guey. I'm a violinist on the violin faculty at the Dartmouth College's Department of Music. Tonight's recital is this season's first concert of the ChamberWorks series, a series of free concerts featuring the Dartmouth Music Department's faculty, students, and guest artists. It is a co-production of the Music Department and the Hopkins Center. Some of you may have attended the Sunday's concerts at Rawlings Chapel at Dartmouth. We are very glad to be able to transform it and bring it to you here on the Hop at Home virtual stage. We look forward to resuming our in-person live concerts whenever it becomes possible. I am excited to share with you this recital for violin and piano that I played with my wife, Lin Guey. We had a lot of fun playing this program. This program gave us a wonderful opportunity to make music while being mostly stranded at home this past year during the pandemic. We called it Brazilian Crossroads. It's a beautiful program of music composed by Heitor Villa-Lobos and composed or arranged by Raimundo Penaforte, a dear friend of mine and a wonderful Brazilian composer who studied and lives in New York, who I've known since the days when I also studied in New York. Mr. Penaforte will be joining us shortly on video to talk about his pieces before we perform them. This program touches upon the Brazilian spirit. This spirit is in the style, in the sound, in how it feels. Perhaps more than in any other piece, it is in the final piece of the evening, in Raimundo's arrangement of the classic Brazilian song from the 1930s, Carinhoso by Pixinguinha. But tonight, the program also crosses over to New York through Mr. Penaforte's arrangement of Leonard Bernstein's West Side Story. And it also evokes Spain through Penaforte's piece based on the theme by the Spanish composer Joaquin Rodrigo. We begin the program with The Song of the Black Swan by Villa-Lobos. In Portuguese, it is called O Canto do Cisne Negro. This beautiful and haunting melody is extracted from Villa-Lobos' early symphonic poem, The Shipwreck of Cleonicus, which in Portuguese is called O Naufrágio de Cleonicus. It tells the story of a black swan that flies over a ship at sea during a shipwreck. This theme is played at the very end of the symphonic poem, depicting the singing and death of the swan itself. It was originally written for cello and harp accompaniment in the orchestra, but Villa-Lobos himself transcribed it for either cello or violin, with a piano replacing the harp. And now, without further ado, The Song of the Black Swan by Villa-Lobos.
Thank you.
Our next piece is composed by a great friend of mine and a fantastic composer, Raimundo Penaforte. I've known Raimundo for decades since our time in New York. Well, my time in New York, he continues to live there. When I was there at Juilliard studying in the 90s, and then Raimundo was there a little before my time, and he has stayed in New York. So he has a dual connection, Brazil, United States, Brazil, New York in particular. And I'm here with you. I would like to introduce you, Raimundo Penaforte.
Hello, Omar. Thank you for having me, and thank you for inviting me to be a part, actually, of this beautiful program that you put together. And yes, it's great to be here, and we will be talking about all these. We'll be reminiscing about our lives in New York when you lived here, and through music. So I think this is like the best way to talk about our lives, and music is has always been a part of it. And we have, out of all the friends that I have, especially you are the ones that one of the few that I still in touch with on a weekly basis. So it's really, really a pleasure to be here.
Yeah, and you know, I've been playing your pieces for like almost like over a decade on a regular, more maybe close to 2 decades on a regular basis as well. Always been a pleasure. And always absolutely thrilled to share with the world. It's a real my pleasure, my privilege. So let us tell us a little bit of your first piece on the program, Hommage a Joaquin.
You know, Hommage a Joaquin comes straight from a melody from Joaquin Rodrigo's Concierto de Aranjuez, which is for guitar and is the kind of concerto that became very well known for the second movement, the slow movement, and one of those things, you know. And everybody knows this tune without knowing exactly where it comes from, unless if you're a guitar player. And someone asked me to write that for, or to arrange that for piano, and I decided to, instead of necessarily arranging, to write a fantasy-like piece on top of that. And so I did. And, you know, in the middle of it, of course, I used some influences coming straight from Chopin's music. And you'll be able to hear that because Lin, your wife, you play this beautifully. I always like when she does that. She has her own way of playing that. So so I'm excited about that. And this piece actually was recorded with a piano and strings by two groups of people that I like. First one is a soloist, Francesco Tristano, a friend of ours, beautiful pianist from Luxembourg, and also Valerius Ensemble, which is a group from Holland. And in 2008, we made a CD with just my music in it. And so that comes from that project. So the violin piece, or the violin arrangement, or transcription, if you will, came much later when I put it aside. And then once we start to talk about a possibility of making music together, I show it to you and you premiere that. And now the piece has become yours. You know, you and Lin, so you own the baby. I'm just here to watch.
It's my privilege, absolutely my privilege to have this. And and you certainly made your own. I mean, the theme will be, you know, recognizable for everyone who knows that, but it has become its own. It has its own character. It has your character in it as well, which is quite fantastic. And of course, you know, Lin, as you mentioned, Lin has opportunity to have a little bit of a Chopin-ish displays there as well, which is very exciting. So now without no further ado, Hommage a Joaquin by Raimundo Penaforte. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Our next piece is by Villa-Lobos, The Moth in the Light, or in Portuguese, for those of you who understand, A Mariposa na Luz. This movement was written in 1917, and then later, a few years later, he used this movement and as the third movement of a suite called The Martyrdom of the Insects, or in Portuguese, O Martírio dos Insetos. And each of those movements are about an insect. The first one is the cicada in the winter, the second one, the firefly in the light, and the third one, the moth in the light. This movement is a very fast and virtuosic movement, just non-stop, fast notes moving up and down. It might, for some people, it might be reminiscent of Rimsky-Korsakov's The Flight of the Bumblebee, but I guess this has a distinctively Brazilian feel. One might think about the tropical forest or the equatorial forest of Brazil when playing this whole suite. And at the very end, as in all three of the movements, all the insects, unfortunately, they fade. They arrive at the inevitable fate, which is death, or, as Villa-Lobos put it, martyrdom. Hope you enjoy The Moth in the Light by Villa-Lobos. Welcome back. Our next piece is a beautiful, beautiful piece by Raimundo, Penaforte, Elegia, or in English, Elegy. I've had the privilege of playing this piece many times with both my wife and other occasions, and it's very soulful and sometimes nostalgic, and I think it brings up the feelings that one might associate with or a morning piece of Elegy, of remembering someone that one loved, that one liked. Well, Raimundo, how about you tell us a little bit more about Elegia?
Yes, and that's true. Elegia, which in English we say Elegy, is a piece that came out of a suite for trumpet and piano. And the idea was to write pieces to use different instruments or different trumpets from the trumpet family. So I did that for Fernando de Senha, as we say in Portuguese, many years ago. And so Elegia is a piece that out of those pieces became very well known to a lot of performers, and they all ask me for a version that they would like to perform their own instrument. So out of that, I did a version for cello and piano, a version for bass and piano, a version also for clarinet and the brass quintet, and you name it. And without being asked, I decided to go ahead and make a version for also violin and piano. And after all, violin is my instrument too. And so I'm glad that I did it. It took many years before I actually showed it to you, Omar, and I'm glad that you decided to premiere that version and have been playing this, you know, for a while now.
Yeah, and I should say, had you not made it, I would have asked you as well. It's such a such a soulful song that, you know, it can't truly be played by any vocal instrument. And that's why, and so beautiful. That's why it's been asked to arrange for so many different versions. It's really evocative and so beautiful. Well, so hope you all enjoy our next piece, Elegia, by Raimundo Penaforte. Welcome back. Now we go to a really exciting piece. Raimundo Penaforte's arrangement of Leonard Bernstein's West Side Story. He arranged three very famous numbers from the Broadway show. The first one is I Feel Pretty. The second one, second movement is Somewhere. And the third movement is America. Yeah, it was a super catch song. I want to live in America and so forth. I've played this many times. It's always fun and challenging as well, but always for a good cause, always fun to play it. The audience usually loves it. Should I say every time loves it. And well, Raimundo, tell us a little bit about your arrangement of West Side Story.
Yes, these three arrangements that you just mentioned, I wrote in 1992. I remember that because I was still working at Juilliard at the music library, and I had just graduated, and I was asked to work an extra month there. And so it was the same time I got commissioned to write these arrangements by Chi-An Kim, commissioned from her. And so I did this inside the library because nobody was really there. And was a very easy but yet naive way of doing this because I had already all my knowledge of the violin repertoire that I could have that not many composers, I might say, would have because I'm a violinist. And so I would just do from my mind exactly what I wanted, and then I just notated. The problem was actually notating more than thinking of it, because I'll think so fast, and I didn't write as fast. And it became a very difficult piece, I realized later, but I thought, you know, Chi-An can handle that. And so she liked them so much that she went ahead and she included in her first CD for Then On Records, and the CD came out the following year, I believe. She went ahead and played these not only in Japan, which was the premiere, but also at the White House for Bill Clinton and Hillary Clinton, some kind of gathering there. And that, you know, and they've been playing by many people over the years, and I'm very happy that you, I always want you to play this. And it took a while for us to get going with that idea, but I remember years ago, you finally decided to do it, and you've been playing them since then, better and better and better all the time. So I'm very happy that you decided to do so.
It's a fantastic piece, so much fun and very, I mean, it's the violin is made to sing, and of course Broadway shows are sung and danced, and this really captures that essence beautifully. So really always fun. Well, without much further ado, West Side Story by Leonard Bernstein, as arranged by Raimundo Penaforte. I Feel Pretty, Somewhere, and America. We'll be right back. We're back for the final piece in our program, this journey of Brazilian music slash going to New York slash going to Spain through Joaquin Rodrigo's music. So we are back to Brazil from the Upper West Side, back to Pixinguinha's Brazilian classic song called Carinhoso, as arranged by Raimundo. This is an absolute classic. It's a song that everybody in Brazil knows. Everybody can hum it. Most people probably know the lyrics from beginning to end. It's a piece that every time I play, I want to just start singing it as much as I want to play it. And what I end up doing, hopefully, is to sing it through playing it. The famous theme is "Meu coração, não sei porquê," and so forth. Raimundo, tell us a little bit about your arrangement of this beautiful song that's almost like a second national anthem of sorts.
Yeah, and you know what you just sang, "Meu coração, não sei porquê." For those who don't speak Portuguese, is "My heart, I don't know why, but beats happily when it sees you." So, you know, you say this to anybody, and they would like to hear that very much. So the music just follows that. It just really backs that up. So it's one of those examples of music and lyrics are just perfect. It's perfect. Well, marriage there. So I wrote this because, the arrangement, for guitar and trumpet, because of a CD I made with Mark Gould, who at the time was the first trumpet of the Metropolitan Orchestra in New York, and it was around 96, 97, and he fell in love with the piece as soon as I showed it to him as a possibility, and so I arranged it for him, and along the way I wrote also for other versions. I made a version for saxophone and piano, or clarinet and piano, and then the last one being the violin version, which I did back then just like an exercise. Sometimes I just do things musically and I put them in the closet, and it stays in the closet for a long time before I had the audacity to tell Omar about that, and of course he wanted to see it right away, and I'm glad he saw it and he decided to play it, and has been playing since then.
Yeah,
beautifully.
Yes, thank you. It works. I mean, it's a song, so any song works beautifully on the violin and any instrument that can sing, which you know a lot of it, most instruments can. And this is a song that, you know, I want to sing it as much as I want to play it. And one day I will do a version where I sing it. I'm going to trick people. Where instead I'm going to be holding the violin, I'm going to just sing it.
You're going to walk on the stage with the violin, but just
yes,
sing it.
Exactly. Yes. Yes. So, well, absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous arrangement. So this will be our final piece of this beautiful program. Hope you all enjoyed this arch of this through the Brazilian music, the Brazilian soul. I want to thank Raimundo for all your pieces, for being here, for sharing your stories, and for your music, for allowing us to, for allowing me to play and to share it. I want to thank my wife Lynn, who did absolutely fantastic job throughout, and she's so it's been a real joy actually in this pandemic to make music at home. Oh. That really, she does her other activities, but during this pandemic when we're all mostly locked in inside home, they was making beautiful music at home. A lot of it, your music, Raimundo. So thank you. And without further ado, our final piece of the program. Oh, Raimundo, please.
Oh, now just before we go on, I also want to thank the people involved in this whole production, especially Todd Campbell, who I just met, and could be a nicer person to work with. And thank you, Omar, and thank Lin for this bravery of playing all this music so beautifully and for making me part of this program. Thank you very much. And also the people watching this at home.
Thank you all for watching. And now, Carinhoso de Pixinguinha, arranged by Raimundo Penaforte. Thank you all. Thank you.